Welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you the easiest way to get a barbell. Just buy a steel rod, or you could buy a pipe as well, and you can make an axle bar. With an axle bar you can nearly do everything like with a normal bar, but it's just a bit harder. You can curl, you can squat, you can bench, you can press overhead, you can deadlift, you can train your grip, and it's even a bar that is used for many strongman competitions. So I looked up in the internet to find one, but they are expensive, like 150 bucks sometimes for nothing else than a pipe. I don't like to buy that. Even now in that times it's hard to get as well. So I bought this steel rod. It weighs around 30 kg. So it has a lot of weight in itself already. And well, what else is to say? You could of course use a pipe, as I already said. Then it's gonna get cheaper and lighter. But I would use at least 4 mm thickness, wall thickness, in the pipe. You're gonna now say, of course, a steel rod in itself, not a barbell. Well, that's right. You need a stop for the blades. You could very easily like glue it with duct tape if you want. But a more professional way is, and that's what I'm gonna try, just use a small blade. This is around 1 pound, 0.5 kg. And because the barbell is 50 millimeter, so you can fit on the blade, of course this blade fits on very well as well. So you just slide it up, measure the distance, and you can weld it to the bar, and you've got a perfect blade stop. So let's start and do this. So before we can weld it, we have to get the paint off on the inner ring. For that we're gonna use an angle grinder. I clamped it to that future flat bench. You can use it perfectly for that job as well. If you're interested in that build, just subscribe. There will be a video in near future. I now measured from the end around 35 centimeters to the inside and used something as a stop for the blade, in my case a prototype of an old color I once made. And now you can weld it to the bar. 35 centimeters, around 40 inches. This is, in my opinion, a perfect size for a 2 meter bar, because you want to have some space inside so you can easily rack it in a power rack or something else, but you also want to have some space to get enough blades onto it, especially if you have some bumpers or concrete plates like I do. So we are done with walling. The bar is now fully usable, but I would recommend to do a few things. To get rid of the sharp edges, I'm gonna use a file for that, because it's Sunday today and I don't want to make noise. And I would also measure the distance between the two plates in the middle and mark the middle. You can use a file for that as well, kind of just a file, a small ring in the middle, so then you later train, you immediately know a center point to put the bar, for example, on your shoulders, then you squat. And of course you should decrease it as well, because it's quite dirty. If you only earn a flat file, I show you, you can also use the edge for filing. Just the edge and you will get a nice groove. The start is always the most difficult part. So now we get the baddest dirt off it. We use something to degrease it, and an old towel. And the dirt from walling can go off. And as you see, it's kneaded badly. Now the bar is finished. It's probably the simplest bar you can make, and I think it also looks quite nice. I want to leave that natural oxide on the bar, so it's kind of black. Well, on the outside it probably will wear off with the time when you put the blades on, but now I really do like the black. Now I have to weigh me, so that I can later weigh me with the axle and we know the weight. I can promise you one thing, this is a heavy bar, heavier than any standard bar. This bar weighs around 34 kilograms. A nice way to curl. So I would say, you gonna subscribe and I start curling them.